Even that's going slow. Okay, we are live. And music, what is your problem?
Everybody doing out there in social media world. Yo guys, come on in. Get your pen and paper ready. We got a powerhouse. We got some information that's gonna knock the clock. And y'all go ahead and share this out and go ahead and send this link out to a lot of people. Let us know where you're chiming in from. We get wrapped up and ready to go.
Now I'm on the way, swear I won't be late, I'll be there by 5 o'clock. Oh, you've been straight.
No, Anita, I'm the DJ. Something she say, you the DJ?
Can we just talk about it? Or we can talk.
Y'all get ready out there. Y'all get ready. We got a powerhouse, Dr. Dennis Martin, in the building. We're going to drop some financial information. Hey, this guy is the expert. So go ahead and get your questions ready. If you guys got anything I want to ask him, go ahead and send them in the comment box. We're going to do everything we can to get those questions answered.
All right. Looks like we gave everybody time to kind of get in here.
Okay.
So y'all ready to get started?
Let's go. Let's rock and roll, MK.
Okay. Now, guys, viewers, I'm going to apologize up front. I got a little bit of a delay on my computer, but we're gonna make this thing shake. Okay, good morning. If you don't know me, I am Melissa King, and I am a MyEcon associate. I am here with my partner, Tony Clopton, who is also with MyEcon, and we are coming in today with a very special guest. So first, let me just tell you a little bit about myself. I have been with MyEcon for almost 4 years. And it's the best decision financially that I ever made. I have zero regrets. Since coming in, I increased my take-home pay by changing my W-4 and started bringing home an additional $800 a month. I paid off quite a bit of debt. Tony and I yesterday were trying to figure out how much I've cash flowed over the last 4 years, And I think the last total we came up with wasn't like close to 50,000.
Right.
Yeah, I was close to 50,000. Okay, since I've been with my econ, I've improved my credit score. It went from late 600s to now it's currently at 834. And I was able to hire my daughter. She is my employee, and I'm able to write off her salary, which she's sleeping on the job right now. But my investment in my econ, I can seriously say, was the best decision I made financially. And that's why I'm still out here encouraging and sharing the word, because a home-based business is where it's at. It's what you need in your life, because we always need multiple streams of income. So now, now that I've introduced myself, I'm going to let Tony tell you a little bit about him, and we will go from there.
All right, great. Thanks, Melissa, for sharing your story. Just like so many other people out there, everybody has a story to tell, whether it's good or bad. Our system, My Econ, is definitely about sharing some information that can change your life financially. So a little bit about myself. I'm Tony Clopton here in Birmingham, Alabama. Currently work in the auto industry for 20 plus years. I can tell you that I've had some financial struggles. We make decent money. But as I've learned that the tax system was really killing me for the last 15 years. So I have a daughter that's 12 years old. Yeah. It's okay. It's okay.
My computer got a mess on right now. Look over there. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Technical glitches. Okay.
Right. Okay.
I'm sorry. Back to what you were saying.
Okay. Okay. Back to my story. Auto industry for 20 years. Mm-hmm. Understand the tax system was beating me up for a number of years. Didn't know what was going on. Why am I making all this money? And I'm still struggling like so many six-figure earners out there. They can make a lot of money, but the tax system, if you don't really truly understand it, you will lose. So before my econ, you're looking at somebody was $500,000 in debt, rental properties, none of the renters are paying. The job market crashed in 2008, and found myself literally living paycheck to paycheck. Now, after my econ, you're looking at somebody that worked the first strategy loan, I was able to get an extra $465 back to my paycheck, right? That's significant. A lot of people don't know that you can literally be overpaying in your taxes. So that's seed money. That seed money I used to pay off some debt. I was able to pay off two credit cards. I was able to pay off two vehicles. And then I was easily put in position to create that emergency fund that so many people need right now. A lot of people are on unemployment. Imagine if your debt was zero and you got that unemployment check coming in. You can live pretty comfortable, right? So what we want to do is just teach you guys some things that we have learned through our system that can help you financially. So what I'm going to do is give you a quick breakdown of what our business model is all about. And then we're going to go into our guest speaker, which I'm so excited to have him on. He's the author of a book, and I'm not going to give it details, but let me go ahead and build out our 243 transformation. And this is our basic training. So you guys stay with me. I hope you guys got a pen and paper ready. We definitely want to share some knowledge that we know is changing a lot of people's lives. So let's dive right into what our system is about. You can literally join this business and just get educated first. We don't try to sell you anything, because we understand that strategies are what's keeping a lot of people financially bound, is not making the right decisions, right? So it's two objectives that everybody have to meet during their working years. The two objectives are: our current lifestyle is paid for by our labor. You're going to work every day. You also have to make enough money for your future lifestyle, and that comes from your investments. But right now, people are literally not being able to live now, because they're not knowing where their next paycheck is coming from. So investments are out the window for a lot of people that's on unemployment. And right now, I'm one that is on unemployment right now. And right now, it's a lot of people are not even thinking about investing. So those are the two objectives that everybody has to meet during their working years. There were two entities that tried to fix this problem, right? The one of the problems was the government. They tried to use Social Security to bridge the gap, right? But Social Security is drying up. Guess why? Because there are a limited amount of people that are putting into the pool, and people are living longer. People are living longer, and you got a lot less people putting in. There will be a deficiency, and you may not be able to get the money that you actually put in. The second one is pension plans. Pension plans no longer work because the government, the corporate America, tried to fix that. Right now, literally, most companies have ditched pension plans. 401ks, they're giving it to the employee to put money in an investment account with limited education. They don't know what to invest in, right? So corporate America and pension plans no longer work because they've given all the power to employees. They're trying to take care of present and past employees. And they were like, hey, we losing too much money and we got to ditch something. So let's go into our four challenges. There are four challenges that are keeping people from meeting those two objectives. I'm going over briefly the four challenges. So if you're writing it down, this is what you need to write down. Four challenges. The first one is inflation. It's called the silent income killer. It literally creeps up on you a little bit each day. Gas prices are a prime example. Meat at the grocery store is a prime example. Of inflation. That means your paycheck remains the same and prices are continuously going up. The second one, we talk about taxes. Taxes take one third of your income. If you make $100, that means the government literally wants 30 of it. What do they do with the 30? Who knows, right? The third one, debt takes the second one third of your income, and a lot of people don't realize that taxes cause debt. So if you had the money when you got paid, you would have had enough money to pay it off. So therefore, a lot of people accumulate debt so they can't really keep a good control of their finances because they're losing a lot of money. The last one is big business. Big business preys on people every single calendar month. There's always something going on in that month where the government, where the big business is preying on you down to the color. They use sports figures, they use songs, they use videos, they even use your kids, right? They watching TV, ooh, mom, dad, I want this new gadget, right? So we go out and start buying things that they really don't need. So we gotta be careful about those four challenges. Once you understand what's keeping you broke, then you can fix it. So I'm glad that you guys are here. My Econ have three powerful solutions to help people overcome those challenges. The first one is correct tax withholdings. Over 80% of Americans are literally overpaying their taxes and they don't even know why. See, if you work for someone else, that means the government is literally going into your pocket and taking money out of your paycheck, right? So what we do in our system, we help you correctly understand how to fill that W-4 form out. Well, you can start literally using that seed money to start correcting your financial situation. So our system is cash flow management first, which shows you how to minimize your taxes through correctly adjusting your W-4. We're going to help you minimize your debt by paying off the debt with that seed money. And then we're going to show you, teach you how owning and operating a business to get the 1099 money. Most people don't realize that you just have to make an attempt to and make an intent to make a profit, proper record keeping. Business, owning and operating the business is not as difficult as most people want to make you believe. A lot of people like brick and mortar businesses, man, but I can tell you the easiest, simplest way is to own a home-based business. You're literally paying things right now, water, cable, cell phone bill, vacation, child's wages, or things that you can literally lower your taxes with if you had a home-based business. Now, these deductions are only accessible to you if you are a business owner. So let's go over a few things in our membership that will help you become a business owner. We have a do-it-yourself credit repair system. Everybody needs good credit. If you don't have good credit, you will literally lose money, right? So once we teach you how to correctly adjust your W-4, pay off some debt, and now you can start building better credit, having the extra money to pay off the debt if you have to. man, one of the most powerful things in our do-it-yourself credit repair system, it literally shows you how to pay off medical bills. It'll show you how to lower your student loans. A lot of people are struggling right now. A lot of people that come into our business only want to understand how to fix their credit. Hey, it's a free service inside of our membership, y'all. Membership has perks. Hey, they got a debt forgiveness inside of that membership, showing you how to get that student loan debt down to zero. Yeah, I said it. You got some people out there got $100,000 worth of student loan debt. Joining our business and plugging into our system, we show you how to lower your AGI where you can literally get a $0 payment. So imagine if you were paying $200 or $300 on a student loan debt, and they reconfigure your expenses and say, "Hey, look, we're going to lower your expenses down to zero. How about you take that extra $200 or $300 and start investing it? If your only payment is zero, why pay the debt? Right? Zero is a payment." So, hey, man, I'm just so excited about sharing this information because we know it is helping a lot of people out there, especially during the pandemic. We want to go into our cashback mall. People are still buying. You can't stop people from spending money that they worked so hard for, right? People are going to always buy TVs. They're going to always buy things they don't want. But who are we to decide what's good for you right now, right? So what we do is give you an option on how you buy it. Why not buy it through your own personal cashback mall where you can get a discount? And in some cases, you can literally write off the purchases as a business expense. Like a couple of Christmases ago, I bought 2 laptops from Walmart. Hey, that became a business expense because I am a business owner. So I was able to lower my taxes because I utilized those purchases as a business expense. So we want to teach you guys how to lower your taxable income by becoming business owners with us. So we're going to move over to investing, right? That's where everybody needs to be. We want to show you how to move your money from the highest tax bracket, a W-2 earner, right? We want to move it over to the lowest tax bracket as an investor, right? So in our business, man, it's so awesome. We are literally teaching people terminology and perspective. What does ROI mean? What does dividends mean? What does gains mean, right? So if you don't know these things, of course, people are going to shy away from it. Man, we got a veteran leadership team inside of this membership that is second to none. Man, I've gained so much information. My daughter's only 12 years old now. She had a little over $30,000 because I found a way to invest my money that gives me a greater rate of return for her. So imagine an 18-year-old with $100,000 in her investment account because of something that I learned. So what we're teaching you guys is passed on generational. See, you're not going to learn these things in school, right? So why not learn it from home? That's why we have to educate ourselves inside of our homes. We have to educate our communities, right? Our churches. And therefore, we can start blessing other people with this information. A lot of people want to say, man, I love the concept. I feel your energy, but I don't want to have to sell anything. Well, guess what, y'all? The only person you have to sell in this business is you, right? We build this business for ourselves. It's in this company, we're not always about making money. We're passing down generational wealth. Man, I'm so excited to give this information for a fraction of the cost to join this business. It's only $29.95 and $34.95 a month. A lot of people will shy away from that. Man, I don't have the money. Well, guess what, y'all? My econ is self-funded. The government pays the bill, right? We are literally showing you how to get the money back from your job if you have one. And if you don't have a job, I bet you know somebody that do. So what we want to do is teach you how to become a business owner, sharing something that millions of people need right now. Now is the time to become a business owner. Now is not the time to sit on the sidelines and say, let's see what it do for you. Well, let me talk to my mom, my sister, my brother, the cat, the frog, the sister, all. See, none of that matters. It's all personal. What are you going to do right now for yourself long after this pandemic comes? I can tell you right now, there will be another pandemic coming. There will be another government shutdown. There'll be another situation coming, and you're going to always look back and say, I shoulda, coulda, woulda. Man, I'm so excited to introduce the next guest, and I'm gonna yield it back over to the moderator, Miss Melissa, because I can get so emotional. Somebody better stop me. Somebody better cut me off, because I can go on all day long. Melissa, back to you.
He is not lying. I do need to stop, because he will go all day long. All right. Thank you for that summarization. you touched everything. I mean, we can really log off right now. You know?
Yeah.
But let's not do that. We have somebody here today, which we are proud to say is home team.
Yeah.
Out of the big city of Cortland, Alabama.
Yes.
He is also an A&M Bulldog.
Go Bulldog!
So we still keep it in the state. when Alabama got too small for him, he took it on out. Now he's in Washington, D.C. And I'm not even going, I'm going to let him go over his list of accomplishments, because I don't want to mess anything up. But without further ado, our guest speaker today is Dr. Dennis Martin. And we're going to ask him a few questions. But first, Dennis, let everybody know who you are, what you do, and how you got the title of, which we're giving you, financial genius.
Thanks. Thanks, Melissa and Tony. I'm really grateful and thankful for y'all to have me on. I was excited for the call. I've been doing quite a few Zoom sessions and conferences in the last couple of months due to the pandemic. But this one here is very special to me because it is home. And I'm going to correct you, Melissa, because we say Cortland, but really from North Cortland. You know, it's two cities down there. We want to give respect for where we're actually from. And if I tell everybody wherever I go around the world, different countries or wherever, about that little small town that we're from in North Alabama. You know, the first time, you know, when I went to the military, people say, well, where are you from? I say, Cortland, Alabama, North Cortland, Alabama. They say, where that's close to? You tell them about Huntsville and how far. You know, so I always give honor to my hometown. I actually was born there. And when I say born there, not in a hospital, actually in my grandmother's house. So I'm a native of North Cortland, a person. And I love talking about finance. Who I am from North Cortland. I am a native there. I even have a little land still there. So I got residents there that I can still call home. Mm-hmm. But thankful and grateful that I was looking for something a little bit bigger coming up. I actually joined the Alabama Army National Guard between my junior and senior year in high school. So I'm a military, a retired Army finance officer. I was an enlisted soldier and a military officer. You know, and got to go around the world and learn a lot of different things. And then that's how I really got into finance. You know, I got in the enlisted in the Army and did about 6 years. And then I decided there was something better. And I was able to get a ROTC scholarship and go to the great Alabama A&M. You know, it was unfortunate at the time that when I came out of high school, we didn't have a ROTC program. And thankful that we do now or have one. And one of the highlights of my career, I could tell you, is when I graduated from Alabama A&M and I got to come back and be one of the guest speakers for one of the ROTC program. It's nothing like giving back from home. But I currently live in the Washington, D.C. area. I'm a CFO for a federal agency here. And been also had a lot of experience working with financial institutions. I've been on the board of a credit union for about 12 years. Been chair of a supervisor committee, which is the audit committee and part of the asset and liability committee. And my plug here is even you can be a member of a credit union board because they volunteer. They don't get paid. So if you're a member of any credit union, I definitely recommend you go in there and go to the annual meeting. And if you can't get nominated by one of the actual members, board members, or one of the people who work there, you can get a nomination and sign up, and you can learn a lot of valuable information from your local credit union or financial institution. So I am currently in D.C. I actually was able to go along and get my doctorate degree from Temple University. And one of the reasons why I wrote this book, and I think we can get into a little bit more detail about that a little later.
Okay. All right. Well, you've done a lot. You're genius. I spoke correctly the first time. Genius.
Yeah.
And not just because you're from North Portland, but you know, you got a shout out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so as Tony was saying earlier, take some notes. There might be some good on the back end for people who are paying attention and taking notes. I'm just going to put that out there. So, you know, hopefully y'all were listening. We might test you, do a little quiz or something at the end. Okay, but now, let's get this conversation started with Dr. Martin. We got a few questions here for you. First of all, congratulations on your book. I did make my purchase. Right there. And it was full of good information. What I liked about it was basic things that every person needs to know, regardless of what background you're from. So let me just ask, first off, what was your inspiration for writing the book?
Right. Great question. And you know, my inspiration behind the book, Financial Decision Making, my dissertation from Temple was Financial Literacy in the Underserved Community and the Financial Decision Making Process. And my first intent was to turn my dissertation into a book. A lot of people go to get the doctorate program and they turn their final dissertation into a book because it gets published. But as I went around the country, and actually North Portland was the first place I went and did a seminar. The question that I received all around the question after the seminar about savings, about budgeting, about financial institutions, about credit, I took all of those questions and I said, you know, as I was starting to look at a book and which way to go, I said, this is what they really need to know. I said, because my dissertation would have been very technical. And I always want to make sure we get the foundation. You know, we all want to invest. We all want to make more money. But as I have talked to a lot of different people when they want to talk investing, I said, well, we probably want to talk a lot about just some basic financial topics first, about savings. You know, do you have that emergency fund? And as we talk about savings now in this pandemic, you know, it's not always about that retirement home or that car or that trip. Well, right about your medical expenses right now. You know, a lot of people go into the hospital and get sick and that hospital bill is coming. And your insurance probably only paying $25 a day, and that bill may be $100 a day. So, and hospital bill is kind of like student loan sometimes. It don't go away. So it's something that you want to prepare for. And as I had other questions that come from me about savings, about credit, and I love Tony's overview about the credit repair business. I talk about that, about the annual credit report.com that you can get on your own and check in your credit from all three credit bureaus. And it was foundational information. And I wanted to make sure it was at a level that anyone, because as I went from Alabama to North Carolina and come back to the DC area and did seminars, you know, you go to some place and they think they already know. And they was a little skeptical, like, hey, I already know this. But I was amazed at who didn't know some of the basic, the difference between a credit union and a bank, you know, why one can have a lower interest rate or that you can be a member. So it's foundational things. I think it's something that everyone can learn something from. I don't care how much information you think you know, it's probably something that you can learn or can pass along to someone else. And it was just actually an opportunity for me to give back, you know, and to get my name out there and hopefully it'd be a blessing to a lot of people.
Okay. Well, I know it was a blessing to me. And for those that are, if you're watching us on Facebook, I included two links that are where you can go to purchase the book. One is an Amazon link and the other one is a PayPal link. So if you click on those, it'll take you straight to the link to purchase the book. Okay, so my next question, you know, for the last 2 months, all we've heard is COVID. So, you know, there were a lot of big social changes as far as people having to convert to work from home and you know, a lot of people aren't working at all because they can't do their job from home. How do you feel this pandemic has affected both the economy, nationally and everybody's personal finances as far as the economy goes?
I would tell you this COVID-19 coronavirus 2019 have affected the nation, the world in a tremendous way. No one could ever predicted it. You know, they talk about it. They had trials and they had scenarios that this could potentially come. But I don't really think that no one could have really planned for a virus that can be spreading when no one even knows they even got it. You know, you got asymptomatic personnel that could be spreading it and don't feel no symptoms. So how do you protect against, as they say, a silent killer? Right. So it is a really, really something that I know in the D.C. area, we're just now starting to go to phase one and open up a few things. But it's going to be something with mass transportation in the most major cities that when people had to get on buses and metros and they got to be real close. It's scary. It's real scary. And on the financial side, you got to realize how this thing hit the financial system. Everybody was pretty much doing pretty well. Stock market was up. People had some opportunity to take two or three different jobs. And all of a sudden, and it was coming around income tax seasons, you know, so it's like, wow, what happened? You know, oil was up over $100 a barrel and it went down to zero. Who would have ever thought? You know, I teach a graduate course on financial decision making, MBA program here in the DMV area. And it was the perfect timing for this, my course this semester, because the first 2 weeks we talk about the economy, economics, supply and demand. Mm-hmm. And everything now, things that you wouldn't even think about, toilet paper and masks, all the products that you used to look over, hand sanitizer, you know, things that you wouldn't even think about. But the thing about on the plus side of it, these are things if you had invested in or had money to invest in earlier, wow, you probably made out pretty good for it. So I think the pandemic is something that I wish my book would have been out a little earlier. And it talks about the foundational things you need to prepare for this. I think Tony went over that earlier. Mm-hmm. We can't wait because it will be another one. You got to have an emergency fund. And, you know, we would love to have 6 months to a year. But what about just 2 weeks? What about a month? Just the next month bill. We're already in 2 months. You know, we can't. I mean, there's a lot of financial advisors out there talking about this. But you got to take care of home first. You got to take care of your mandatory things. You got to take care of your food, you know, your shelter, your insurance, your kids, you know, and make that your priority. Always make that your priority. And as you look at other things to pay, you know, no one never want to pay the minimum amount. But at this point in time, you got to do that and take care of mandatory things first. So this pandemic, it will get better. And as you see, the market has already started to rebound some. It was a great time if you did have savings to go. I mean, I personally bought some casino stock and some cruise stock because it went down, it went up, and it's a perfect time to buy, you know, when things are down. But you got to understand the foundation first, and which I try to talk about with saving and budgeting in my book about things that are happening now.
Right. Wow, this is great. This is great. So I'm going to add on that this definitely was a wake-up call for a lot of people. It's been some people who have never thought about savings until now. There's been some people who never even thought about emergency fund until now. So, of course, my econ was in the perfect position. Just like you said, people starting to look and raise awareness, man. The reset button is now. The wake-up call is now. So what will you do to position yourself for the next time? And I'm telling you, I believe everything happens for a reason. Unfortunately, it happened. But I think that some people got to get hit over the head before they can make a decision to do better. Now is the time. So that's awesome information, Doctor. We appreciate that.
Yeah.
Right. And you know, the other thing that I was reminded of last night before I was going to bed, I'm listening to the TV, but not really watching it. And I hear a commercial where they're, you know, advertising the best face mask. And I'm just like, man, if we don't live in a capitalistic society, I tell you what, who would have thought 6 months ago that there would be a market for face masks? So I'm just like, boy, they on top of it. They are on top of it. Okay, so next question. when I was looking at the dedication in your book, I noticed that you dedicated it to your kids. And so I myself, I'm a parent, a single parent, and generational wealth is something that we in my econ, we focus a lot on. So I'm gonna pose this question to you. If I was a child growing up in Dr. Martin's household, what type of financial lessons or planning or preparations can I expect to hear from you from age 0 to 18?
It's a great question. And you know, the great thing about this question, I have two adult kids and I have two grandkids. And I talk about it in chapter one, where one of my foundation is scripture is Proverbs 13 and 22, where it talks about a good person. And then I look at that as, you know, a good person, you know, leaves an inheritance, not to their kids, but their children's children. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I say, well, you know, I can't be a hypocrite and be talking about this and not living it. So, you know, the first thing as kids, you know, really at about 7 or 8, you know, kids know where money is, ATM cards, credit cards. They know what that is, but you got to show them, you got to expose kids, take them to the bank. You know, they can get children accounts, you know, show them how the bills are paid, you know, show them, you know, thank God I've been in a pretty good situation that when I was growing up, your parents would tell you they don't have it. No, I'm going to tell you I ain't going to have it. I tell you I'm not going to do it, and this is the reason why. Right. And it's okay to tell your kids that. You know, we all want our kids to have be better than us and have better things, but at what cost? You know, there's things they can do for their own, and you got to teach them money habits. It's not taught in school, like Tony said. You know, I got a undergraduate in finance, a master in finance, and a doctorate degree, and nobody's talking personal one-on-one consumer finance. Another reason behind my book, because I know a lot of educated financial people that still don't know personal finance. There's a lot of entertainers, athletes who pay 8-10% for items that we probably paying 3 and 4 because they say, I got the money and I'm going to just pay it anyway. So it's not just the people who live in underserved areas. So giving them that foundation, teaching them, you were here being taught, you would get to go to your financial institution, you would get your own bank account, and you get allowances. And, you know, even I got a good friend that talks a lot about education when time to go to school, you know, making sure trying to get a scholarship, Pell Grant, or all the other resources. So exposure, making sure they can see people like us doing great things, making sure they understand our financial institutions, banks and credit unions, and just educating them as much as you can, because it starts with them. A lot of the reason a lot of adults don't know because their parents didn't know and they really didn't get an opportunity to learn. Just to add to that, the government spent a lot of money on financial literacy. Believe me, people don't think they do. I got no counties up here in Northern Virginia that they got some serious financial literacy program, but it's not in North Portland, Alabama. It's not in where we're from, and not in the minority neighborhoods. It's in the neighborhood that already got a lot of taxes, and the schools are already good, and they're making sure they continue their legacy. So a lot of education, a lot of training, a lot of discipline on financial literacy.
Man, this is great stuff. Boy, my heart is overjoyed. Oh, wow. So when you say something, it triggers something in me, man, because it's great to hear this coming from a professional and expert like you. Me and Melissa both were in position where we took a tax class. And one of the first strategies that each time taught us was publication 15, how to hire your child. A lot of people don't know you can hire that child up to $12,000 as a tax deduction to the parents, right? We learned this. So, man, if you're not, you're right, doctor, if you're not getting this information, where do you get this information? So I'm just so overjoyed to hear this. I'm getting goosebumps just talking about it. It's just, I know that this is confirmation all day that we got to start teaching our kids. And this is one thing that really ticks me off when people say, I will go broke for mine. Now, what sense does that make? Because they seeing you, they watching you. They literally will go broke.
Yeah.
Right?
Oh, yeah. Boy. And they got a lot. You talked about it earlier, Tony. There are lobbyists, especially here in the D.C. area, that are making sure those payday loans, those 36% loans, those rental centers, those pawn shops are in major the man in our areas, and going broke for yours. And when you understanding that because you live, work, or worship in a certain area, you can be a member of a credit union and get a $5 account. But what we say, we don't want those people in our business, but we would rather go down here and pay 36% for a payday loan. So, I mean, it's like you have to show them the money that they're paying and show them the things that guys you really, but then again, sometimes they just do not know, or they listen to someone else and they just haven't been educated on that particular topic.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, MK?
I tell you what, Dennis, you just gave me, I have PTSD when it comes to payday loans.
I've been there too.
And when you said payday loan, I caught a chill. It was like, ooh, I don't want to go back. Yeah. I don't want to go back. But I totally agree. You know, and you brought up a good point. It's like you want to make sure your kids have everything, but you also want them to learn how to value what they have and the concept of earning versus having it given. My daughter came in yesterday while I was working, and she said it was like an app or something she was going to do. And she's like, it's only $1.99 because, you know, I got everything password protected. She got to run it by me before we agree to anything on it. So I said, okay, but I'm going to need you to go in that bank in there and bring me out $1.99 because I'm not playing this game coming out of your pocket.
Yes.
And she brought me this little dollar bill and paid for her game. Okay, so next question. You did speak about the churches and the religious part of why it's important to have your finances in order. In chapter one, you mentioned the Proverbs verse. Do you feel like, because just like it's not always taught at home, it's not always taught in the church. How do you feel as far as like teaching finance in church?
Great question. I seen Tony posted it on Facebook the other day, and I was like, oh, he finna start a war, right? Yeah. I started to jump in. I'm saying, no, I'm not going to say nothing on that topic. But this is one thing I do like about going to school, and I'll tell you this story before I answer that question for a reason, because when I was going through my doctorate program, the first advisor I got, you know, my testimony, we didn't see eye to eye, to say. He said we was incompatible. And so I had to switch advisor, which was the best blessing in the world. Things happen for a reason, like Tony say, because the next person I got is over the program now, and my advisor mentor is very well known. And it happened for a reason. And as I was doing my research, all of my seminars really was in minority-owned black churches. From pastors I know or friends I knew from the military, I went to their hometown areas. And I went into black neighborhoods, into our churches, which is the core for our organizations. And I went there and gave the seminars. And some of the churches, what I say, was of higher income level, and some was not. And it was praises received from all. You know, the Bible talks about finances all the time. You know, the second verse I use in my book is talking about Proverbs 22:7. It's talking about the rich rules over the poor, or you're a slave to the lender. So if I don't see how you can really teach the Bible if you're not teaching financial wealth and understanding that principle. You know, that's me. But I do believe it needs to be someone vetted. It needs to be someone who truly is in your best interest. Right. It needs to be someone who is known. Even some of the credit unions and banks, and I talked about getting our mayors and city councilmen and people of that neighborhood to get people to come in and to teach in our neighborhoods. But they do need to be vetted. Because you get a certified financial planner or somebody who's pushing particular products, they're going to make sure they push that product. So it's a difference in what you're teaching instead of you teaching just basic financial literacy. So, yes, I do believe it should be, but I definitely think it should be reviewed, vetted, and making sure that person is talking about certain things that will help everyone.
Wow, this is good. Doc, I appreciate that. So
I'm gonna tell you what really made, what prompted me to put that post out, man, just to make people think, right? They know that churches is where people get their spiritual feeding from, right? Everybody understands that. But I do believe that, like you say, that they speak wealth in the Bible. And I think that, I think a lot of pastors have been burnt probably by allowing people to come in. They need to be vetted. People that have the congregation's best interests at heart. Just like our company, MyEcon, it's not solely about commission-based. It's education-based. So just going in and just talking about credit and talking about how to get cash flow positive and start investing more, and some of those basic principles, whether it's the biblical principles that are already there. Our founder always talks about Deuteronomy 8:18, man. And I tell you, when I first heard about this, I've never heard a multi-million dollar earner that speak about God giving him the power to gain wealth and being able to share it with other people. And he's just such a giving spirit, man. And I wanted to try to understand, why are you still working? I mean, I thought once you make it to a certain level, I stop, you know, but I don't think there's no stopping when you ask God to give you something that can help people. Your journey is not over. So I was, you're right, man. I think people, I think pastors have been burnt. I think you're right. They need to have a committee of people that understand that, what are you actually teaching? Go over the curriculum and to see if it's going to benefit the church, right? Yes. Build a stronger foundation, man. So that's awesome, bro. I appreciate it.
Oh, great. Great.
Yeah, I appreciate that too, because, you know, a lot of times people have a concern that when people come in to speak finance, they have their own agenda. Mm-hmm. So I like what you said about vetting and making sure it's somebody that's looking out for the interest of everyone. So I think that's a great point. Mm-hmm. Chapter 4 in your book, you talk about taxes and how it affects your pay. Give us a little breakdown on that, because that's a big part of my income. We teach people how to update their W-4s.
I think Mr. Clark and Tony did a great job earlier talking about how, you know, you got $100, $30 of it, you might want to throw it away. You won't see it. Taxes is key. I mean, understanding your taxes, not just your regular income taxes, but your daily taxes you paying on everything. I first retired out the Army in 2009. And Tony, you'll love this. I think my official retirement day was like 30 November. On 1 December, Martin Financial Solution was created and was founded. A lot of people don't realize that. And where I learned it from, because a lot of senior officers I've seen that they always had a company when they was in between jobs, so they never was unemployed. Mm-hmm. But you also give you that tax benefit to write off as a consultant, or talking, and it helps so much. Understanding your taxes is something that, you know, I recommend you do try to get a CPA instead of just someone doing your taxes. There's a lot of great companies out there. It's very specialized, but back to what you all are focused on, owning a business, that's the best tax write-off you can ever have. Anytime you can write off your car, your home, your phone, your computer, what we're doing right now. So I love Tony videos, you know, your marketing, you know, so it's amazing on how they can lower your income. Right. And something else, I don't know if you all have those, like a self IRA, you got your 401k, but as an employee of your own company, you can put up to about $57,000 into your company that will reduce your taxes. You know, I'm fighting with a tax provider right now that I'm educating her, and she's supposed to be the specialist on between my regular 401k, TSP, and my company, the multiple venues you have there for writing things off. And I think the key is what Tony said is, you got to attempt. You don't have to make money every year, every day, but you got to be attempting. If you got another job, say like Tony or I have, and it's supporting that business, you know, yes, they may look at it, but if you got a legitimate business, you still can write off some expenses that people don't realize you can write off. And I know we don't take advantage of that. And MyEcom, or whether you're getting your own LLC, MyEcom, of course, you know, it's a lot cheaper, because the average LLC probably is about $200 and get you a PO box. So about $250, you got your company, you know, mm-hmm. So wherever you at. So find out your passion, find out what you can do. And I definitely believe if people don't realize, I think we're talking about during this time now that you need multiple streams of income. If that job is closed, what else can I do? Mm-hmm. You know, I started not to sign up for teaching another course here later on. But then I say, what else am I going to do? Because I'm like Mr. Clockton there. If I want to walk away, I want to be able to do that and be able to do something else and don't be. Mm-hmm. That is our biggest prize, your multiple talents that you have, the way you can make income. Because you never know when you're going to get sick or something may happen.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. It's great.
So true. And that kind of ties over into another question. We were a little bit afraid to ask you about it because we didn't know whether you know what you said. But you talking about multiple streams of income. The multi-level marketing, such as My Econ, as far as having your own home-based business.
Well, I love what My Econ do. I had heard about it a while. A few friends that have the company, and I had my company for a while, and I love the premise of it. And the first thing, like you all stated earlier, education first. You know, you got to educate people first, and that's what you do. I mean, a lot of companies try to give you a scenario, a multi-marketing firm. They just tell you about the income portion of it. But what you all are doing now today is just bringing in special guests and talking about basic financial literacy. You know, this is, I charge for this, you know, so mm-hmm. I'm not charging. This is Home Team. This is what we do, what you're supposed mm-hmm. to do. You know, I went to school to get this certification and credibility, so I could charge because of my background and my experience. But if you don't take advantage of that mm-hmm. any way you can, as far as having a business, whether it's My Econ, another business, or whatever, you got to find a way. And for the price that you all are charging, I think we talked about it the other day. It's what you put into it. I had a lot of friends that talk about the military, but Lord knows that was the best blessing that ever happened to me coming out of North Portland, Alabama, for mm-hmm. me personally, for what it had paid for and what it had done for me and my family. Mm-hmm. And some people go in and do well, some people don't, but it's what you make out of it. My mm-hmm. Econ, whatever your business, mm-hmm. it's the same way. You got to work it. You got to put in the work.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
Right. That is a great point. And, you know, one thing I like about, like you said, you get paid to do this. You know, this is your background. My Econ has people from all different backgrounds. My background is the medical services field. Before joining this group, my financial literacy was probably remedial. Mm-hmm. I have been held back mm-hmm. because there's so many things about finance
yes.
that in your day-to-day, you don't really think about. And then, you know, people tend to want to shy away from the conversation too, because if you were like I was prior to joining, I didn't know the language.
Yeah. I got to jump in there. Financial literacy, finance particularly, especially in the minority community, is such a private topic. Nobody right. want to let them know how bad they're doing. They want to see right. you driving the car, the house, mm-hmm. and mm-hmm. really they don't have $1,000 in their bank account, mm-hmm. but they look good. Or people mm-hmm. that making a lot of money, but guess what? What are they doing? It's all going out. So mm-hmm. we got to get away from that stigma. Mm-hmm. I talk about it a little bit in the last chapter when I'm trying to home everybody in, and it can't be the man got to be the main breadwinner, or the woman, or my ego won't let me let another woman make more money than me. We got to come together as a team and mm-hmm. look at, hey, how can we be successful together as one? Because it's okay to let someone know you need help. I think that's our biggest problem sometimes. Mm-hmm. You can talk mm-hmm. to your creditor. You can talk to your lenders. You can talk to people about, well, what are you doing? Someone you trust. Because like you say, everybody may not be in it for your best interest. Mm-hmm. But we got to be a little bit more open if we're going to learn.
Right, right. I think a lot of people have to literally push the walls down. A lot of people, like you say, are their ego or they're too prideful. Everybody's going through something right now. Now is not the time for you to say, oh, I'm good. Oh, I'm straight. You know what I'm saying? I hear a lot of that. And I say, well, you straight, but you know, you're not working. You got a house, no car, no water, cable. What are you doing? How can I help you? Yeah. That's why I'm so passionate about this business, because I know what we have can help a lot of people. And I've literally given my business, man, the company gave us coupons to allow people to come in for literally free. I mean, and people, if you don't get the level of understanding on how this business works, it won't work if you don't learn it. You know what I'm saying? So it's an educational process first for us. And man, it's a trip how people can say I'm good. They struggling. They live in paycheck and they afraid to reach out. That's why it's so important to tell your story first. So somebody can say, hey, that's me too. Everybody needs to have a me too moment. You know what I'm saying? Hey, I'm struggling. I'm on unemployment. I'm struggling. Me too. So what are you doing for yourself? Well, let me show you a little something about what I do myself. So that's how you can get people to tear down the wall and let them know you're not the only one struggling, but this is what helped me.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Okay. So another question. I know you have the banking background and you're on the board with credit unions and everything. One of the things we learned about in my econ was the rule of 72, and they call it the banker's secret.
Can you tell the secret? And I would tell you, the rule of 72 is something they give out for the public. And I would say to the regular customers. And the rule of 72, as you may have learned, is basically just how you can determine a long-term investment, like how an investment can double their money. You know, a good example of if you got $1 and you got a 10% interest, how long will it take for that $1 to turn into $2? You know, at a 10% rate. You know, and it's crazy because you take the rule of 72, you know, you divide it by that percentage, and that's almost 7.2 years. That's a long time, right, for $2 to make another dollar. So right. The banks, you ain't making no money off the rule of 72.
Right.
You know, when you get CDs at a bank, read the fine print, find out is it getting compound interest. Is it monthly? Is it quarterly? Is it semi-annually? Or is it annually? It makes a difference, because if I'm getting it every month, you know, I'm getting a certain percentage, and then now that's making money. But is it only semi-annual or annually? That 3% or whatever they're saying they're giving you, you're not getting a lot of money. So the rule of 72 is just tell you how long it takes for your money to double. Banks, credit unions, most all financial institutions. The secret I like to share is that when I was doing my training, I was the Army Banking and Credit Union Officer in Europe for about 3 years when I was in the military. And I found out that when the Federal Reserve come out and said they drop an interest rate or they raise an interest rate, and everybody like, oh, what's going to happen? Inflation going to go up, or this going to happen, or interest rates should drop. Banks and credit union don't worry about that. You know why? Because they don't borrow their money from the Federal Reserve. They only get their money there for a certain amount. They go to other institutions and get their money at a better rate so they can lend it to us for a higher rate so they can make money off of us. So it's an educational process. It's a good tool. I could take 6 weeks and teach the rule of 72 in a class, but in my own personal, I'm like, I don't really worry about it because I'm not trying to wait that long to double my money. But it is a good thing to know how to. I would say it's more of a book, technical book, but personal one-on-one, I wouldn't get too excited. I'll try to find out when I'm getting interest, if it's monthly, quarterly, or semi-annually on my actual investment.
Okay, great. Okay. So it's safe to say those who do understand interest win, and those who don't lose big time, right?
I think one of the, Franklin, someone about compound interest is the key to everything, you know, knowing how and when your money get more interest. You know, if you can set it in the bank and just make money $30 or $40 on it, $200, hey, it's great.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good deal.
Okay, next and almost last question, or is it the last question? Okay, now, you know, we talk about how all of us have gone through things, and you know, I just had my PTSD moment. If you could go back to before you were Dr. Dennis, when you were like early and just starting out, what is the one, or what are some of the biggest financial changes that you would tell young Dennis to do so you could get where you are now faster?
I think everyone, like you say, may have had a loan or something that was at a higher rate. I know I did when I first went into the military and went out to El Paso, Texas, paid a loan. Thank God I was in the military and lived in the barracks and didn't have to worry about a meal or food. So I could just spend my money and didn't know what I had to do. But I think some of the biggest thing to learn, to think about, if I could go back, knowing that I wasn't educated on it, is to understand your benefits. And that's on a job or wherever you're at. You know, a lot of people say, well, I'm trying to get promoted, or I'm trying to get training, I'm trying to get some education. Your jobs be offering you tuition reimbursement, or offering you a certain program to get a certification or a training. If you're on a job and there's no way for you to get promoted, what other benefits do that job have for you? Do they have any training, a certification? Because you got to maximize that. If you got a 401k or TSP and you have reached your foundational goals of emergency fund and things of that nature, because a lot of us, we start talking about investing and we don't have the basics down yet, but we may be on job and not taking advantage of free money or money that we could get from the organization we're working with. I think when I was in the military, when they first came out with TSP, our version of 401k, and it wasn't matching, I really didn't get involved into it until probably a couple of years later. I think I missed out. It was a great program. I think I'm using it as a federal worker also. But just starting earlier, learning about real estate or renting a home or buying a home earlier. You know, sometimes we get scared. You may have the financial earnings, but you don't really know how to go about doing it, and you get a little scared. So I think all mistakes we learn, it's a reason for it. Like Tony said, you learn better. You maybe have a true story and maybe have a testimony that you can help somebody else. But I think just taking advantage of things that maybe you knew about but just didn't do, you know, and maximizing all the opportunity that you have for its benefits with your job or another particular organization or volunteering. For example, people ask me, well, why do you volunteer? Why was you on that board for so long? Do they pay you? I said, you can't imagine being on a $1 billion financial institution, the information you learn. You can't buy that. Mm-hmm. You can't buy that information. You can't apply for it. You can't get selected for it. You know, you got to get selected for it. So it's certain things you can volunteer and learn some things sometimes too that you just never know.
Right. Mm-hmm. Ooh, good. You went over so many things, like my feet hurting because you were stepping off. You know, that was such a great point that you brought up about with the job and the benefits, because you're right. If you take a job, most of the time we only look at the salary. We don't worry about the benefits or if you'll be able to be promoted. And then you find yourself in the same spot for 20 years and, you know, in a 2 or 3% raise every year, you haven't really moved. So that's something, you know, that's a good point. A lot of people don't think about that. With that, you know, I was thinking when you're talking, I could write my own book about what not to do.
Share it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I might not be able to write the one you wrote, but I can tell you what you want so that you will need one, bro. And with that, then my next question is, well, do you see yourself writing another book? And if so, you know, what pointers or tips for upcoming authors or people who are interested in helping other people the way that you did, you know, what can we expect to see from you?
I definitely see myself writing another book. I really want to make this a series in a sense. Like I said, I teach this in an MBA program on the corporate level, graduate level, here in this area also. This is the foundation. We got to crawl before we walk. The majority mm-hmm. every time I do a seminar or talk, everybody want to know what to invest in next or find out about investing. So that may be the next level book, spoiler alert, that goes into that next level of financial decision making. But once you get this financial decision down, and we might talk about, I got a few of my friends who are investors and certified financial planners, and talk about those things, the next level of financial decision making. So I do plan on making a series. Anyone that is looking into writing anything, don't do it alone, guys. Ask for help. Find someone who mm-hmm. have written a book and ask them what do they do. It's a lot of different, you Google it, a lot of information come up, but go to someone who you trust, who you think you can ask. I actually had a coach, and the coach was a friend that I knew from an executive level course I went to back in 2012. And she, Dr. Lisa Banks, she had wrote a few books, and she walked me through, paid her, and it was great. You got to have thick skin, because once you put it out for somebody to review, you got to realize talking in your own voice and making sure your message is your message. Give credit what's credit due. It's not a term paper, but you want to make sure you got proper references and check. So it's something that, and there are so many different types of books out there. If you're passionate about something or you're a subject matter expert, it's kind of like YouTube and on the internet. You see people got, they create something for everything. And then people make a book for everything. So I think it's something that, and like Tony, I think said, well, I think when he purchased my book, it's another source of income, and it makes you an author, and it can open up other doors for you. So anyone got any recommendations or thoughts or questions for me, please, they can reach out to me at info@martinfinancialonline.com. I'll be glad to help them or bring them.
Okay. All right. So we made it a little bit past the 1 hour mark.
Sorry.
And I've gotten all of my questions out. I wanted to leave it open if any of our viewers would like to ask questions to Dr. Martin. Please feel free to type in the comments, and we'll let Dr. Martin answer those. Also, we were telling you before to pay attention, because we might have something good for you at the end. Tony, what you think?
Okay, so what we're going to do at this time, while you guys are coming up with some questions to ask Dr. Martin, we got four gifts that we're going to give out. The first two gifts is going to be pertaining to my presentation in the beginning of the video. If anybody can tell me the four challenges that everybody has to meet during their working years, we're actually giving out one half off coupon to join our business. And we're also giving a free book of Dr. Martin's financial decision making on the first. So the first two people that can give us the four challenges that everybody has during their working years, please go ahead and drop them in the comments, and we'll send us your email and name, and we'll get you guys those gifts out.
Right. What better? You come and you listen to the speaker personally, and then you get a copy of the book.
Right.
Come on.
You're right.
For the win.
Yeah. So Melissa, we'll let you do the last question during Dr. Martin's video session. Whatever question you want to ask, and we can do the same.
Okay, so let's see if y'all were paying attention to Dr. Martin when he was speaking. For the question pertaining to him, let's do a good one. Okay, if you can name at least one of the educational institutions that he attended for his many degrees, at least one. The first two people that can give me those will also receive the same gift. So I hope y'all are paying attention. All right. While we're waiting on that information, do you guys have any final thoughts, tidbits? I would just like to say personally, I like this conversation, because it was with everything that's going on right now, all week, everything has been so heavy. It's nice to be able to go to a topic that we all can talk about, where we all can win. So I appreciate, and I've learned a lot. I appreciate everything you shared, Dr. Martin. Mm-hmm. So I appreciate that. Tony?
Okay. Hey, you guys go out and get the book.
Financial Decision Making, Understanding Your Options. I think it's a great read. It's not long. I actually finished it in about an hour. Soon as I got it, I jumped right on it, man. And I was like, wow, man, light bulb was on all day. I probably did about 5 or 6 videos from this one book, man. I was super excited. So I guarantee you guys, especially to the My Econ team, this is a great book to have to be able to share with your team as well. It definitely talks about everything that we're doing in My Econ, and it was definitely enlightening and confirmation for me to get this book.
Now, so thank you. You showing up. You, I read it in about an hour.
Sorry. I ain't had nothing to do that. any questions out there from any of our guests?
So far, I don't see anything in the comments unless I'm missing, you know, we shared it on every facet of Facebook.
Okay.
But on the main screen I'm looking at, I'm not seeing any questions so far. So if you do have questions, please feel free to, you can still, this post will be up on Facebook. You can still ask questions. And what was your, I want to do a banner real quick. With the email you gave us,
yes, the email address is info@martinfinancialonline.com. info@martinfinancialonline.com.
Okay, so make sure I did this correctly.
And you can also buy the book at Amazon and what's the other outlet?
On my Martin Financial, my PayPal account, martinfinancialonline.com.
Okay.
Martin
okay,
Financial.
Okay. Good deal.
Does that work, Dennis? The way I
type it out? martinfinancialonline.com. And that's my website. On there is a link to the book, Financial Decision Making.
Okay, great.
I think we have a comments. I think we did. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. Me and this phone.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. That was something else. All right. Well, if that is all, now, guys, we're going to be leaving this post up. So we're still giving away those prizes. First two people. What was your question, Tony? The name of four financial challenges?
Right. Four financial challenges. I definitely want to give our closing remarks as well. I'll start and then we'll end it with Dr. Martin. I can be reached at tonyclopton.com. That is my personal page for My Econ. I can be contacted through there. Our business is $29.95 right now. The company just unleashed a new product of hand sanitizer. You can buy it in bulk. Hey, it's capitalism all day. We know people are going to be looking for that. We do have it. That's my plug. And in my closing remarks, I want to say this. Mentorship is key when it comes to helping you understand and building wealth and getting over hurdles. Network marketing can be a great thing, especially what we do. We have educational a platform behind it. I always want to stress this. Get some leverage income. Now is the time that we have to understand that we can't always do it by ourselves. But when you got a team of people that is collectively building, like group economics, helping everybody understand how to create wealth, we start to build our communities up and our churches, helping understand that the information that we're sharing is not taught in school. So we have the blueprint to helping you build wealth generationally. So I just want to continue to educate first. And foremost, it's not always about how much money you make it, but understanding what to do with the money once you get it. So in closing, always look at mentorship, the networking part of it, and just connecting with like-minded individuals to help you build your wealth.
Exactly. Okay. So Tony's two questions was, name the four financial challenges. My question again is, name at least one institution where Dr. Martin got one of his many degrees. Mm-hmm. As my closing, I just want to thank you for joining us, Dr. Martin. You have been a great guest. I hope you will come back.
Mm-hmm. Anytime.
Look, for free. I hope you will come back.
For free.
But, okay. I'll just add, I really appreciate your wealth of knowledge, and you look like you know what you're talking about.
Might know one or two things. But thanks again. Thank you all for having me. I really appreciate the opportunity. And if you need anything from me, feel free to reach out. And I definitely would love to support. Thank you, y'all. I love what you all are doing too with my econ. Great, great things.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
All right. Thanks. Well, thank you, gentlemen, for joining me. We're going to wrap it up now. We're at an hour and 15 minutes. Please see the link below on the Facebook page to order the book. They are both the paper link and the Amazon link, info and martinfinancialonline.com. If you have questions for Dr. Martin, and you know how to reach out to us, Tony and Melissa are on Facebook. And Dr. Martin has a page also on Facebook. So look him up, like, and share. Mm-hmm. And thank you guys for joining us.
Thanks.
Y'all have a good afternoon. All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.